Hello everyone, welcome to CAD/CAM CE tutorials. In this video we are going to design Geneva wheel mechanism that you can see on the screen right now, and then we will give it the motion. So now let's have a look at a motion. So now let us begin it. Now we'll close it, then we'll go to the file, select here the new part, OK, then go to the sketch, select here the top plane. Now first draw a circle of 100 mm diameter. Then exit the smart dimension, then select a circle and draw a circle like this, and draw two horizontal lines from the circumference points. Then go to the smart dimension. Now the circle diameter is 12 mm and here the length of this line is 30 mm. Now we'll exit the smart dimension, go to the trim entities, and we have to trim this. Okay, then select the center of the circle and the origin and make it here horizontal. Okay, now select all the three entities, then go to the circular sketch pattern and select here 6. Okay, now select this endpoint and select the circle, make it here coincident. Okay, and do the same for this point. Now the sketch is fully defined, then go to the trim entity and trim out this portion. Okay, now we have to draw one circle, so select here the circle and draw one circle like this. Go to the smart dimension. Now the circle diameter is 40 mm and the distance of this circle from the origin, that is 60 mm. Now we exit the smart dimension. Now select here the center point of the circle and the origin, make it here vertical. Okay, go to the trim entities, or let before that we'll make the circular pattern. So select the circle and select here the circular sketch pattern, enter here 6. Okay, then we'll go to the trim entities and trim out this portion for all 6. Now we'll exit the sketch, go to the features and select your extrude boss feature and enter here 8 mm. Okay, now again we'll go to the sketch and select here this floor face, make it normal. Now draw a circle of diameter 25 mm. Then exit this sketch, go to the features and select your extrude boss feature, and depth of extrusion is 10 mm. Okay, again go to the sketch and select here this lower face, make it normal. Now here again we will draw a circle of diameter 15 mm. Then we'll exit this sketch, go to the features and select extrude boss feature, and depth of extrusion is 20 mm. Okay, now we'll make it plain white, then select the part, go to the appearance and select here this blue color, there is plastic, high gloss and blue color. Now we'll save it, so go to the file, save as, and here we'll make a new folder on the desktop and select here new folder, and we'll name it as Geneva mechanism. And we'll save this part and name it as Geneva wheel. now we'll go to the file, select here the new part, okay, go to the sketch and select here the top plane. Now we'll draw two concentric circles like this. Go to the smart dimension. Now the distance between the center of the circle and the origin, that is 30 mm. Now here this inner circle is of 15 mm dia and outer circle is of 40 mm dia. Now exit the smart dimension. Now select your line and we'll draw two horizontal line like this. Then go to the trim entities and we'll make this entity trim. Exit the trim. Now here we'll insert a vertical center line like this. Now select these both lines, make it here horizontal. Okay, now select the sketch, go to the mirror and select here this center line. Okay, now we'll exit the sketch, go to the features and select here extrude boss feature and depth of axis is 10 mm. Okay, now go to the fillet and the fillet radius is of 3 mm. Then select this lower edge and this upper edge. Okay, now we'll give it appearance. So before that we'll make it plain white. Select the part, go to the appearance and make it green color. Now we'll save it, go to the save as and name it as a base. Now go to the file, select here the new part. Okay, go to the sketch and select here the top plane. Now here first we'll draw one circle of diameter 80.68 mm. Then we'll exit the sketch, go to the features and select extrude boss feature and depth of extrusion is of 8 mm. Okay, again go to the sketch and then select here this lower face, make it normal. Now here we'll draw a circle of 15 mm dia. Then we'll go to the features and select here extrude boss feature and depth of extrusion is of 20 mm. Okay, now again go to the sketch and select here this face, make it normal. Now here we'll draw a circle of diameter 40 mm. Then we'll exit the smart dimension, again go to the circle and draw a circle over here. Then we'll go to the smart dimension and distance between these two circles, that is 30.06 mm, and the circle diameter, that is 50.44 mm. Now we'll exit the smart dimension, select the origin and select here the center point of the circle and make it here horizontal. Okay, now go to the trim entities and we'll make it trim. Then we'll exit the trim and go to the features, select here extrude boss feature and the depth of extrusion is of 10 mm. Okay, now again go to the sketch and select this face, make it normal. Now here we'll draw one circle of diameter 12 mm. Then the distance between the origin and the center of the circle, that is 30.06 mm. Exit the smart dimension, select here the origin and select the center point, make it horizontal. Then go to the features, select here extrude boss feature and depth of extrusion is 10 mm. Okay, now we'll make it plain white. Select the part, go to the appearance and make it here yellow color, and then we'll save it and name it as a mover. Okay, So till now we have created all the parts, and now let us make assembly of all the parts and then we will give it motion. So first let us go to the file, select here new, and make sure that here you select the assembly. Okay. Now first we'll insert the base, then we'll insert the Geneva wheel. Now we'll go to the mat, select here the cylindrical face and this cylindrical face. Okay. Then select the lower face and this lower face. Okay. Now we'll insert the third component. So go to the insert component, select here the mower, then go to the mat, select here the cylindrical face and this cylindrical face. Okay. Then select this lower face and this lower face. Okay. So our assembly is completed. Now we'll make it plain white. Now we have to give it motion, so we'll go to the motion study. Now first we'll make it align, so we'll make it normal. Now we have to move the component such that it makes perfectly aligned. So that I am doing on the screen right now. And we will move it up to this. So it's looking perfectly aligned. Now, first we'll increase the timeline. Then here we have to select the basic motion. Now we'll modify some settings. So go to the setting and give the frame rate as 30. And here the geometry accuracy, make it high, and 3D contact also make it high. Okay. Then we'll give it the 3D contact. So select here the contact. Then select here this part and this part. Okay. Now we will give it the motor. So select here the motor. Then select here this face or this part. Now here we will reverse the direction and make it motor RPM as 20 RPM. And here we will select the base. Okay. Now we will make some calculation. So click on the calculate. So it has calculated, and now we can play the motion. So click on the play button and your animation is here. Hope you enjoyed the tutorial. For more videos on SolidWorks tutorials, please subscribe to my channel CADCAM C Tutorials. Thanks.